Seymour Hayer, aka White Death. The Winter War was a military conflict between the Soviet Union and Finland in 1939 to 1940. It began with a Soviet invasion of Finland on the 30th of November 1939, 3 months after the outbreak of World War II, and ended with the Moscow Peace Treaty on 13th of March 1940. The Soviet Union wanted Finland's land to protect the city of Leningrad.
So sweet a room, so strange and you.
The Finnish troops were led by commanders Risto Riedi and Carl Gustav Emil Mannerheim. The picture you're looking at now is Risto Riedi. The Soviet Union invaded and started a puppet communist government in order to secure land to protect the city of Leningrad in exchange for other land for Finland. The Soviet Union was led by leaders such as Joseph Stalin, Kirill Meretskov, Kliment Voroshilov, and Semyon Timoshenko. At the time, Joseph Stalin was the current dictator of the Soviet Union. With the outbreak of World War II, the Soviet Union looked to expand its borders and capture more territory for protective or other reasons. The Soviet Union looked to expand west towards Finland, Sweden, Norway, and other Western nations in order to protect some of the main cities on the West Coast. Because countries like Finland extended so far north, the temperatures got very cold and saw a lot of snow during winter. With all of these snowfall and otherwise harsh temperatures and weather, the soldiers had a hard time getting around and staying alive, simply because of the cold. However, all of the snow did provide good cover for snipers such as these few men, setting up in white camouflage in between bushes covered in snow. They could be barely seen by the enemy eye.
The sweetest room I ever saw.
Although the Soviet Union started with almost three times as many men as Finland, Finland used its knowledge of the terrain and their white camouflage to outsmart the Soviet Union and end up winning a lot of battles. It was in this way that Simo Haiha got his over 505 confirmed kills alone. And to add to the 505 kills, he also got these 505 kills over a period of 100 days. Simo had to lay in the cold snow with his harsh temperatures and nothing but white camouflage for hours on end until he saw a few targets. He would then take out his rifle and slowly pick a few of them.
Pardon me, boy.
Yes, yes.
Is that the Chattanooga choo-choo?
That's the Chattanooga choo-choo.
Since Simo was such a good shot, he was able to pick off multiple members of the same
group. She says the Tennessee line. Check. She means that she can't afford. I can't afford to board a Chattanooga.
After firing a few rounds, Simo would have to lay still for even more hours on end until he's completely sure that no more Soviets could find
the Pennsylvania station about a quarter to four.
He could then walk out and see how many people and report that back to his
family. Your ham and eggs in Carolina. When you hear the hooker blowing eight to the bar, then you know that Tennessee is not very far.
Conditions were better. The Soviet Union still had tanks, bombers, cars, and infantry running around at all times of day and night. Still, every day, Seymour would go out to a different position and wait silently in the cold to pick off a few Soviets. And to add even more difficulty During the winter in Finland, there are very few hours of daylight. Add a little bit of irony. Hinock preferred to use the Finnish militia variant of a Russian made rifle. And then, you can see a little more awesome. He would prefer to use iron sights rather than a telescopic sight, because of a smaller target for the enemy. Through countless counter-sniper and artillery strikes, Hi-Hot was able to shoot. However, on March 6, 1940, Hi-Hot was shot in his lower left jaw by a Russian shell. He was picked up by fellow soldiers a few hours later, and they said, half his cheek was missing, but he did not die, gaining consciousness on March 13th, the day peace was declared. Thanks to his amazing feats, Hi-Hot was promoted from corporal to second lieutenant by Field Marshal Carl Gustav Emil Mannerheim. No one else has gained ranks so quickly in Finland's military history. His jaw and blown off a portion of his flesh. Nonetheless, he made a full recovery and became a successful moose hunter and dog breeder after World War II, and hunted with the Finnish president, Urho Kekkonen. With more and more people learning of Hi-Hot's amazing feat, more and more news and press wanted to cover him. When asked in 1998 how he became such a good shooter, Hi-Hot simply answered, practice. On that famous thoroughfare, with their noses in the air. When asked if he regretted killing so many people, he said, I only did my duty and what I was told to do as well as I could. For a wonderful time, with your blue. Hi-Hot chose to spend his last years in Ruokolahti, a small municipality located in southeastern Finland, near the Russian border. He died in 2002. Hi-Hot's amazing accomplishment shows that anybody, when they put their mind to it, can accomplish anything. As he said, he got to be such a good shooter by practice. To look like Gary Cooper, super duper. Come, let's mix where Rockefellers walk with sticks or umbrellas in their mitts. So I leave you with a small joke. A little girl in New York City asks a police officer, how do I get to Carnegie Hall? Practice, he replies.